Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Thomas, and I've now been in Seoul for almost 2 months, and it's been a great experience so far. That is not without some growing pains, though, and I'm here to tell you guys and anyone else who's never traveled here before some things that they might notice right away. So even if you're just here for a short time, the first thing you'll notice is that when you go to a restaurant, it's not so, let's say, formal when it comes to ordering food. So let's say you're from the West or in America, you sit down, you talk with the waiter, you can just go back and forth. Do I want water? I don't want water. Actually, maybe this drink, let's have appetizers. And then they come back several times, are you ready to order? The whole process takes a long time. In a lot of restaurants here, in which there's definitely more of a more emphasis on small businesses, at least here in Seoul. But with these small family restaurants, it's very fast paced. When you do order, you just say over here. It's not rude at all just to call for help, to get loud and, you know, yell across the restaurant to the employees to help you out. We'll get inside. We'll usually order right at the entrance. The menu will be on the wall, or there's a sign somewhere. And even if there is a menu when you sit down, they're very much expecting you just to know what you want pretty quickly. There's no back and forth, not too much small talk. The next thing you'll notice when you're out and about is that Korea is definitely known for its fast and efficient delivery services. So let's say you're walking around the sidewalk and there will be a lot of motorcycles and scooters, mopeds, whatever you call it, on the sidewalk, and they'll sometimes be just zooming right by. Also, cars will use the sidewalk to park sometimes. When these motorcycles and scooters are making deliveries, they are very decisive when they're getting around. Sometimes I'm wearing headphones. I'm trying not to wear headphones so much when I go from place to place. I'm trying to learn Korean and listen to audiobooks, but the motorcycles will just zoom by you. So even if I hear them coming, I'm trying to react. They're already making a decision of where they're going. Watch out for motorcycles, mopeds. Don't be offended if they get really close to you when they drive by. The delivery business is very fast. A lot of these people are working all day long and they're trying to just make their way through. And also about the trains, the train system is very efficient. It was really intimidating at first. There's, I think, 12 main line, and then there's also express trains and long distance ones that go out of Seoul. I haven't really been taking that many of them. The one near me where I live is Line 2. Line 2 connects to a good amount of other train lines. The etiquette on the train, especially when it's really packed with people during rush hour, things just are calm and nobody's really trying to talk too much or make a fuss about what's going on with their day. If they're with a group, they're usually still quiet until they get off the train. Also, there are seats that are pink and purple that are 2x2 seats facing each other. Those are reserved for elderly people or people that you just know need to sit down or need some help. And just overall, things are, for the most part, quiet, calm. When it gets really packed, it starts getting hot. You know, people are probably already irritable. I've tried my best just to take up little space, get in, get out. It's just made to be efficient. People are getting in and out because it's very much a normal routine to them, so it's nothing special. Later at night, yeah, people are going out, they'll talk, especially if the train is more empty. But usually when you just read the room, read the cart that you're on. A lot of people also take the opportunity to fall asleep on the train. Be very aware of the train etiquette. Next thing that I really love about this country, and I think for my district specifically, because it's near at least two or three colleges, so there's a lot of students who study day and night, and that is the cafe culture here. So cafes are pretty much seen as kind of a universal place that people can socialize day and night. In America, you might be at a happy hour on a weekday. Maybe that restaurant or bar you're at is open until, you know, 11 or 12, but then you got to keep buying stuff to, you know, to really rationalize staying there longer. Some people, they just buy one coffee and they can just hang out all day. And if they're studying, especially, they can just bring all their stuff. There are actually several 24-hour cafes right near me. And of course, they're always filled with students any day of the week, late at night. And you wouldn't even know how late it is because it's still busy. And some people will socialize and some people will be studying. Yeah, I really like that because I can't think of any, especially corporate chain, that stays open late enough. And it's just way different out here. I mean, cafes are, like I said, they're made for any type of occasion. If it's a big group of people or just you and one friend, you want to go to a cafe after or even before you go to lunch or dinner. You just want to hang out longer if the night is young. You can always just say, let's go to a cafe. Now on weekends, they do tend to close earlier, but wherever you are, at least in Seoul, if you look on nearby cafes, you'll at least find one or two that are open till midnight or so. It's just a really great way to stay out if you don't want to be cooped up where you live. Last thing that I heard all the time, because I actually met a majority, I think, of my friends through social apps such as HelloTalk. It's a language exchange app, but it's also for meeting friends. And there's plenty of people that want to meet foreigners and just learn about it. A lot of people that have talked to me said they're about to travel to the UK or America for working or studying abroad. They always brought up, at least because this was the time I started visiting here, was the cherry blossoms. So everything was just like, people would say, oh, have you seen the cherry blossoms, or did you see it? And I used to think maybe it was some sort of like one singular event or like a Coachella type thing. It's really just like the biggest transition of the natural environment here to show that it's springtime. There will be different parks and just different areas, and yes, maybe smaller festivals and stuff where there's just cherry blossoms everywhere. And lots of people were posting about it. And I actually never paid attention or tried to go to any event related to the cherry blossoms. But I've seen some people do like photo shoots and really time it well with, let's say they're at a forest or a park. And yeah, it looks really cool. If you get a chance to see cherry blossoms with a group of friends or at any particular type of event, apparently it's really worth it, and I really kind of regret being totally clueless to that. So those are five things. I hope you enjoyed listening to that, and I hope I helped improve your knowledge of the Korean lifestyle and living in Korea.